afternoon. We're sitting here in Los Angeles, California, visiting with Gail Edgar Wasson today. Uncle Gail's going to talk to us about the family history. So why don't we start out with your grandparents? What do you remember?
About my grandparents?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I can remember my father's parents very well because we lived on their farm till I left home. And they were out to our house every week, maybe once or twice a week. He was watching how the crops grew, and same as my dad. So I had a pretty good connection with my father's parents.
What were their names?
William Sheldon Wasson and I can't remember. Susan, I couldn't think of that. And Susan Wasson, my grandmother. And my mother's parents, I didn't have quite as close a contact with them. They lived about 20 miles away. But we always were good friends. They came to our house and we went to their house. Of course, it was quite a trip when we went to their house. Had a horse and buggy to go 20 miles, stay overnight and come back again the next day.
How long did it take to go the 20 miles?
Oh, 2 or 3 hours. That's a long time to sit in an old buggy, too.
And you just loaded the whole family up and went?
Yeah, sometimes we'd have all 7 of us in a double rig. Sometimes we'd have 2 horses and sometimes 1.
Now, where were they all from originally?
Well, I don't know how far back it goes, but my father's ancestors came from Ireland and my mother's ancestors came from Germany. But I don't know how far back that was.
And they all settled in Indiana?
No. The Pepple family, my mother's family, lived in Ohio. My father was born in Ohio, just across the line, and we were raised up in Indiana. Of course, it was only 2 miles from our house to the state line, so we didn't consider states all there. It was all one place. They had the post office on the Indiana side, but everybody in Ohio got their mail from Union City, Indiana, anyway.
Well, now your mother's parents, what were their names?
Calvin Pepple and Frances Pepple. That's a funny thing about Dad. When he got married, his father-in-law had his first name, and his mother-in-law had the same birthday as his. Both on May the 4th.
Well, now, when you remember visiting with them, did you all have Sunday dinners together, or how did you get together? Was it special occasions, or did you just get in that buggy and go visit?
Well, usually we just get in the buggy and go visit, but then usually some of the other family were there, and we have 2 or 3 families visiting my Grandma Pebble. Have a big dinner there that day, then we... Granddad always had a peculiar way of doing, but he would invite all of the kids and their families in for a big dinner on some Sunday, and he'd give each one of them a little money, maybe $200 or $300 apiece. And that day, that meant a lot of money, but he used to just like to give some money away. Of course, he was raised on a farm, lived on a farm, but after he left the farm, he bought hogs and sent them to butcher places in the city, Indianapolis or Chicago. He made himself quite a bit of money at that. So he'd get a little extra money on it, and he'd give it to the kids so they could go ahead and enjoy it.
Well, that was nice. How old was he when he died?
85 years, 10 months, and 7 days.
And what about your grandmother?
She was a year younger than him. She died the next year, so she was practically the same age.
And you were closer to your father's parents?
Yes, because they lived closer, and we lived on their farm.
And what kind of crops did you raise?
The regular corn, wheat, oats. We had a lot of truck work and tomatoes and things like that.
And how old were you when you moved to North Dakota?
Ask Uncle Finn, that's my mother's brother. He lived in North Dakota, and he had them to come out there to stay. And I asked him how old I was when we went there. He says, you were 14 months old. Well, that was right. I was born in February and we went up there in April. And we stayed there 3 years. And then Dad had 160 acres, had it all in wheat, was all ready to cut. He cut one round around the whole big field. And came a hailstorm and beat it into the ground. So he says, that's enough for me. So he moved back to Indiana.
Oh, my. Well, now...
I was 4 years old when I came back.
So was everybody born by then, by the
no.
time you moved back?
No. Roy, Glenn, and myself were born in Indiana there. Earl was born in North Dakota, and Elmer was born back in Indiana.
And what year was everybody born?
Well, Roy was born July the 19th, 1902. Glenn was born November the 22nd, 1903. I was born February 22nd, 1905. Earl was born October the 4th, 1907. Elmer was born October the 22nd, 1910. That's the whole works.
So your grandmother was busy.
Yeah, she was busy.
Well, they didn't have any washing machines and
I've pushed the old washing machine many, many, many times.
Well, now did you have indoor plumbing and...
Yeah, we had a well just outside the door of the shed around it, so we didn't have to go outside to the well, but that was our plumbing.
Oh my gosh. Well now, when do you remember when you got electric lights and things like that in your house?
We never did.
You never did?
Not till I was after off with farm. We used to use, we had good lights. She'd get these mental lights made of good white bright light. We always had good lights to go by, but you couldn't just go turn them on. Go to the trouble of lighting them, heating the metal and lighting the light.
Oh my.
Had to use the old lantern to go to the cow barn to milk the cows.
How many cows did you have?
We usually had 8 or 10 cows.
And did everybody split up the chores?
Yeah. Everybody had their cows to milk.
Well, did all of you brothers get along? Did anybody ever get in any trouble?
Oh, well, I'll let you guess on that. Kids always fight amongst themselves. They'll fight each other and they go someplace else, they'll fight for each other.
Well now, is it true that you were the favorite child?
No. I don't think I was.
Well, I heard that you were the favorite, that Grandma liked you the best because you were the nicest.
I'll tell you why. There was Roy and Glenn, older than me. They went out to the field to help Dad with the farm. There was Earl and Elmer younger than me, she had to take care of, so I was the one left between to help her in the house.
Oh. Well, what happened when you guys got in trouble? How'd you get disciplined?
Oh. We fight it out ourselves. They didn't, they knew we wouldn't kill each other, so they just let us try to work it out ourselves.
And what'd you do for entertainment?
Well, you take a bunch of kids like that, they play jackstones, they'll play puzzles, they'll do most anything to entertain themselves in the wintertime. But Dad was always good to us. He was a good reader. We'd bring books home from the library and things like that at school. He'd have us all to get in a chair and he'd sit down under a light and read to all of us. We'd all get the same book at the same time. But he was a good reader and he'd just read to us.
That's wonderful. Did your mom like to read?
She did, but her eyes were never good enough to do much reading. But she did like to read in her younger days.
Was she pretty when she was young?
I thought she was.
Was she? I mean, do you remember how
yeah,
she
was? Yeah, I remember. She was a nice looking woman. She wasn't quite as heavy when she was younger, but she was a little plump and not as heavy as the older days. I remember one time somebody got in a raspberry patch about a mile and a half away from the house. And that's before she got so heavy. She'd run a mile and a half over there and run the guys out of the raspberry patch in the woods.
Oh, that's something. Well, so how many years were your parents married?
They were married 47 years.
And how old were they when they got married?
Dad was 33 and Mom was 26.
So they got married quite old for that time.
Oh, yeah, sure.
I wonder why that was.
Maybe they didn't find anybody until then.
Well, I mean, women used to marry 18, 19 back then, didn't they? Generally.
Oh, I know that they did. They felt like they are now, I guess.
Well, do you remember what kind of school you went to?
Yeah. I started the school. We used to have them school districts. I went to number 5 one year. Then we moved from the 60-acre farm over to the 100-acre farm. I went to number 4 two years. And then they had the Wayne School built. Then we all went to Wayne High School, a centralized school. Everybody in the county went there. Our township, Wayne Township.
And what year did you graduate from high school?
1924. I was the first one in our family to graduate.
You were?
Yeah. And Earl and Elmer after me graduated from high school, too.
But the two oldest boys never graduated?
No.
They just went straight to farming?
Well, Roy didn't. He started when he was just a teenager. There was a man named Charlie Lipp. He used to build houses. And Roy went to work for him, helping him build houses. Then he went into the factory and worked in the Union City Body Company practically all of his life. And Glenn went to the factory for a while, and he didn't like very much in the factory, so he got a farm and moved on a farm, put the rest of his life on a farm.
Were your parents upset when they quit high school?
They didn't like it, but then you can't make them learn anything if you make them go, so they just had to let them drift out.
Well, did anybody go to college?
Well, I was the only one. I went to Muncie Business College and went from there into the bank.
And how long were you at the bank?
I put in about 15 years.
That's a long time. What did my grandfather do when he got out of high school?
He went in, I think if most of his time was spent with Wolf and Sons Dry Goods Store. He went in as a salesman in the dry goods store.
Did he do that for a long time?
For several years, and he went to Belle Fountain, Ohio, to work in a body factory there, something like one in Union City. And he met a lady by the name of Lena Swick. And they went together for a while, and they got married about 1928, something like that.
How long did they go together before they got married?
Probably a couple years.
Did you meet her before they got married?
No.
And how long were they married before you got to meet your sister-in-law?
I don't remember how long it was, but I remember he brought her home one day, and we didn't anybody know her, but he was glad to bring her home. And he was telling her before, he says, now don't worry anything about when you get there, because they may all just crowd around the table and shove each other and grab for something to eat and this, that, and the other. And her thinking we were a bunch of heathen.
Well, that is
something. She kind of swallowed it down until she got there.
Well, did your mother like all of her daughter-in-laws?
Yes, she had seemed like a special liking for Lena. They seemed to like most things alike. They liked the same things, I mean. And they got along real good together.
And then when he brought her back home, were they still living in Ohio? Or?
Yeah, they were living in Belle Fountain.
And do you remember how long they lived there?
Well, let's see, 29, 30. Well, maybe a couple of years. Because they were living in Muncie when Roger was born. No, they lived in Muncie before that. They moved to Union City in March. I think Roger was born the 27th of March, and he was just a little tiny kid when they moved there.
So mother was 3 or so.
Yeah.
Do you remember the first time you saw her?
No, I don't. They lived in Muncie when she was born, and I don't remember.
And where were you living then?
Union City.
And so when did they leave Muncie, and where did they go?
They came back to Union City to stay for a while. After the folks moved to town, they had a little house in the back of the yard, and they moved in that little house and stayed there for quite a long time. I don't know, must have been a year or more.
And what brought your parents back into town?
They got fed up with the farm, and they just wanted to get to town and make a little easier living.
So how did your grandfather make a living when they moved back into town?
How did my grandfather?
Or your father, I'm sorry.
Oh, he worked at little odd jobs for a while, and then they moved out to the country again, on north of town. And he had a little farm there he made a living off of for a few years. He used to raise corn, acres of corn. He'd go out and pull the corn off 3 o'clock in the morning, bring them in town, and the people would almost be standing on the street waiting for him to come along. They liked his corn so well. He made good money at that.
My gosh.
He'd just drive down the street, unload a load of it, go get another one.
And how many acres did he have when he was doing that?
Oh, maybe 15 acres, something like that.
How big a town did you grow up in?
Well, it was known to be 3,500 in Indiana and 1,500 in Ohio. It made a city of 5,000 people. One post office on the Indiana side, so people from Ohio got their mail from Union City, Indiana.
And your police force?
We had one man, Joe Hoke. He didn't
guess
have any automobile.
Chief,
he just walked around town.
He didn't have any crime then?
No, I never had any trouble.
Did most people that grew up there stay there, or did a lot of people leave?
They had to leave. There was nothing there for them to work at. So and as they grew up, they spread out in different places.
Was there any industry there?
Union City Body Company was the main one. Of course, there was other small businesses, but they didn't employ many people.
Did they make buses or something like that?
Body company. They made automobile bodies. Touring cars and things like that back in those days.
Huh. And so your brothers worked there?
Yeah.
But they didn't like it?
Well, Glenn didn't like it. He's a farmer boy at heart. So he went to the farm, and Roy liked it, and then the factory, so he just stayed there. I worked there about 3 weeks, and I got out and went to work in the bank.
Well, I would say that you were the smart one. Probably a little easier work. What did you do in the bank?
I started in as an individual bookkeeper, and then I got second year, I got the head bookkeeper, and I did all the clerical work.
And how many people did you have in the bank?
Oh, it must have been about 7, if I remember right.
Was it the only bank in town?
No, there was 4 banks. I was in the best one, but I was in that one. There's 2 there now, I think.
Is the population still the same now?
About the same, yes.
Well, now, what do you remember, what exciting things happened while you were growing up there in the world?
Well, when I was 9 years old, World War II started. I can remember a lot of things about that. Of course, they didn't have it like now. You get a newspaper once a week. You get all the news of the war every week instead of every hour.
Well, how did that affect your family?
Well, it didn't affect our family because none of us were involved in the military.
Did it affect the kind of goods you could get at the store? Or?
Well, a whole lot. I know we go to town to buy flour, for instance. To make bread. You could have so much flour if you bought so much cereal. We come home with maybe a 50-pound bag of flour and a half a dozen boxes of cereal.
Now, why did you have to do that?
To keep you from eating so much wheat bread. Huh. They had to have it for the military and things like that.
Well, I guess there weren't 20,000 kinds of cereal back then either, were
there? No, they were. We had post-toasties, shredded wheat. Rolled oats.
Well, so your flour was rationed. Was anything else rationed?
No. We just had to keep the flour within reason, and that's the way they did it at that time.
I mean, who judged what was within reason?
Somebody in Washington, maybe. I don't know. I was a kid. I don't remember.
So when you were 9, World War II happened, but nobody in your family?
I was 13 when World War I was over. I can remember the whistles blowing and the thing that went on when that was over in 1918. And then World War II came along. I had to register for the military in October of 1940. And 30th of October, I started out to Los Angeles and landed here on November the 1st. I got a job here and worked a year before December the 7th, 41, when the war started.
And how old were you?
I was 37. I went in the, let's see, 37. No, I was 36. And I went in on November the 27th, 1942. And in December the 4th, when Roosevelt declared anybody 38, when they come to 38, they can get out. When I turned and came 38, I got out in 43.
What branch were you in?
I was in Army Air Force. At that time, they didn't have any regular Air Force. It was Army Air Force, Navy Air Force, Marine Air Force, all had their branch. But after that, after World War II, they took it away from all each one of them and made one big Air Force.
And what did you do in the service?
Oh, I was in the radio department. I went to radio school, worked caring for radios, and well, I was in a good section. I was in a branch that was training pilots. So I didn't have any overseas calls or anything like that. And we always had the best of chow because it was going to be lieutenants when I get out of school. So we had it really good while I was in the Army.
Well, did any of your brothers have to join up?
No, I was the only one. I was the lucky one.
Well, did you know your lovely wife at that time?
Nope, I didn't meet her until 1944.
Well, how'd you meet her?
I looked right at her.
Where was she the first time you saw her?
I met her up here in Beverly Hills, or no, Westwood Village, at the Sonia Henney Ice Rink. We were skating that night. I didn't have anybody, when they called for partners, I didn't have anybody in mind, so I saw her and I went and asked her if she'd skate with me, and she said, uh-huh.
And the rest is history?
The rest is history now. I never got sorry about that either.
Well, you've been married a long time now.
It'll be 43 years in April, April the 3rd.
And what was your anniversary date?
April 3rd? 48.
And then when did Phil come along?
He came along in 49.
Well, he did.
April the 3rd, 48 to January the 29th, 49.
So you didn't get to be married a whole long time before you started your family.
No, she didn't want to. She had been taking care of kids for a living, you know. And she wanted her own child so bad she could hardly wait. So she got a good one.
Well, that's wonderful. So Phil came along in 1949, and what were you doing at that time?
I was working in a bank in Washington.
Now, when did you move back from L.A. to Washington?
We left here on December, I left here on December the 7th, 1947. She went back by train. I drove back. I worked with him myself. Drove back, and then we met in Union City and went on to Washington and had Christmas there. And in the early part of February of 48, we were married.
What made you decide to go back east?
Oh, we just wanted to go back to her family and things like that.
So did you have a big wedding?
Four of us there.
Four of you?
Myself and her sister and her husband.
And where did you get married?
In the Church of the Nazarene in Washington, D.C.
A long time ago, and you still remember that day?
Sure.
Well, and so when you went back to Washington, how long did you stay there?
Let's see, we went back in 47. I started work in the bank on February the 19th, 48. Worked there till June the 6th of 51, and we came back in 51. And I went to work in a bank here. July the 6th, I worked there about 6 months and wasn't getting anywhere with it, so I quit and went to work for air research out here, a manufacturing outfit. Worked there about 2 years, and they had a big layoff. 1,500 people got laid off. I was in that much. So I went to work then over at McDonnell Douglas and stayed there the rest of my working days.
Did you like working for McDonnell Douglas?
Yeah, it was a very nice place to work.
They have good benefits, don't they?
Pretty good benefits, yes. They have a little pension fund. Of course, they didn't start their pension fund until 1961, and I left there in 1970, so it couldn't build up very high. But we get a little benefit from that, and I mean, you know, their medical benefits. For 17 years, I had all my medical benefits free. But now the government complained about that, so I have to pay about $20 a month for both of us.
You're very lucky about that. Well, now, other than World War I and World War II, what other big events have you been a part of?
Raising Phil. I don't know, we always had a good time together. I've enjoyed my life with that guy. Rose and I both have. I don't know, any big events. I don't know of any big events.
Do you remember where you were when... Do you remember ever thinking that man would walk on the moon?
No. That was one of the things that I think was a big event when they got so they could go to the moon and come back.
Yeah, coming back was...
One of the biggest things to me was television. How they could send pictures. When I was in the Army and we were in radio school, they tell us they're getting so now they can send pictures through the air like that radio. I couldn't believe it. And it wasn't very long until they had TV in everybody's house.
Do you remember when you got your first TV?
Yeah. We got it when Phil came home from the hospital. No, before you got home from the hospital. We used to come home and bring you home on Saturdays and look at it a little bit.
It was a black and white one.
Yeah, black and white.
And how many channels did you get?
Oh, I get a regular... two, four, five,